outside of working for a moon landing, there were more challenges for NASA employees and contractors.
You knew when you went to work that what you were doing was important. I think the only downside was, particularly for married people with family, it took its toll.
All of us went home at night to our families. Well, my wife would say, "How was it today?" And I would only say one thing: hectic.
Especially on the Apollo program, it became sort of your whole life. It was exciting, it was challenging, but it was a lot of job satisfaction.
As one who is a member of the community, and I have a family, and you know, I'm trying to function as a father and a husband, and I have to admit that got challenged because of the intensity of what we were doing out here.
Well, we had a lot of divorces. We had a lot of young electrician guys on, and they were down here and they were making swamp pay and overtime. They'd work for 6 months on a vehicle, and we'd get like 2 months off in between if we were lucky. And they wanted a party, and there was always a launch party too at the end of the thing. So I got calls 3 days after the launch, you know, "Where's my husband?" You know, what do I know, you know? I got named as a correspondent in a divorce case as the guy's boss because I made him work so much overtime.
I know that there were family issues. I, as a manager, had to, of course, you know, deal with that. And I had to counsel people that in spite of how hard we're working, I recognize you got to have some time. I don't want to say things like, "Well, yeah, the divorce rate went up." It did, you know, during those days.
Share your own moon memories with WUCF using the hashtag MoonMemories or on our website, wucf.org/moon. Don't forget to watch Space Chase USA Thursday, July 11th at 9 p.m. on WUCF to reminisce more about Central Florida's role in the journey to the moon.